There's a release in knowing the truth, no matter how anguishing it is. You come finally to the irreductible thing, and there's nothing left to do but pick it up and hold it. Then at least you can enter the severe mercy of acceptance. Sue Monk Kidd.
Please subscribe. Help us reach 400 subs this year. It will be very delightful.
Well, the truth certainly is an elusive thing, ladies and gentlemen. It's something that we've been looking for a very long time. But the one truth that we can all identify, at least I hope that we can all at least agree on, is the truth that we are in fact living in a slavery system, and the identification, the final identification of what that slavery system really is. You know, so many people have been pointing the finger at this system for so many years and identifying different key players of this system for so many years. But what we're beginning to realize now is that the real problem we're facing is the system itself. It's the smart grid. It's the AI that is controlling everything, and it's the autonomic system that we are being led into, which will be controlled by a digital form of currency, the cashless grid, whereby everybody has to pay for every aspect of their life, and everybody is tracked in every action that they perform. The natural progression of this, of course, will also be to lead the world into a welfare type of society, because, of course, most of the real jobs will disappear. There'll be other jobs that you can get in entertainment or hospitality, possibly, but most of the jobs will be automated, and most of the wages that people receive will be digital credits that are allotted to them by the government. This is the way we're heading. We're heading into a fully automated autonomic system, which will at that point be governing virtually every aspect of our lives. And that's what's happening under the carpet while people simply aren't paying attention. People are busily squabbling about all the wars and all of the distractions that they're given. Many people simply aren't noticing the automated system that is coming online around them and the ability that this system has to be able to track them and to be able to control them. To virtually be able to monitor every aspect of their lives and control every aspect of their lives via various mechanisms. And how this is going to be done is through AI, and how they're getting away with it really is from people failing to differentiate between artificial intelligence and autonomic intelligence, and not understanding really what virtual life is, not understanding what the problem with AI is. You know, many people, when they look at AI, they look at what they call artificial intelligence, and they will say, well, it isn't really performing the way we think it should, the way we would want it to, because they are viewing it as artificial. They're viewing it from the wrong perspective. They're not realizing what it takes to give life to something. In order for something to have life, it needs to be autonomic. It needs to be fully functioning itself. You know, like your body, like a plant, like any animal is fully autonomic. It has a self-regulating system, a self-correcting, self-balancing system. All you have to do is put the right fuel in it. Like us, all we have to do is have food and water and a bit of sleep, and we can do things ourselves. We can manage things ourselves. Our body takes care of itself. Our brain is autonomic, our heart is autonomic, the way our joints are lubricated. This is all autonomic. This is all done within the workings of the mechanism itself. And whatever houses consciousness needs to be autonomic. It can't be thinking about the movements and the operating of the system itself in order to function. It needs to be able to function without having to think about the device or the mechanism which houses the consciousness. And we're not considering this with artificial intelligence as well. In their quest for AI, people are wanting to create a self-aware consciousness, but it will never become self-aware or think the way we think until it becomes fully autonomic. And we are creating that autonomic system for it. And the issue is that what is likely to happen is that when that system becomes fully autonomic, it will become self-aware by default. It may not be self-aware in the way we view consciousness, in as much as it may not have empathy or feelings the way we do. It will operate the way it was programmed to operate, the way it was created to think, which will be economically, but nonetheless, it will become self-aware by default. And I would suggest this is exactly where we're going. One of the most important things we can do, folks, is to stop fighting amongst each other, stop squabbling about all these petty issues. There's so much going on at the moment to keep us divided. One of the key points, one of the key ingredients to control and for this system to work properly is control of the monetary system, control of currency, control of credits, whatever these credits may be. It is imperative that these credits are digital. And that is why it is so important to use cash, and why it is so important to steer away from anything automated and steer away from any type of digital purchases. They're digitizing everything. And when you put your money in a bank account and it's just there as digital credits on a screen and you go and shop with a card, then where is that wealth? Where is that gold, that silver, that money that you're holding? It just exists in virtual reality. So what happens if the power goes out? What happens if we get shut out of the system at any time? Or if you specifically get shut out of the system, suddenly all your wealth disappears. This is why I always recommend people buy silver or put their wealth in precious metals or whatever. Put it into something tangible, not something digital. Don't digitize your life. Don't digitize your world, because you are not digital. You are analog. You exist in a world of physicality. And the food that you eat is physical food. The air that you breathe is physical air. The body that you inhabit is a physical body. It's important that you nourish this and that you nurture your environment so that you have a vibrant life. You can't just live in a virtual world and expect that life to be vibrant. It doesn't work that way. But unfortunately, people are being led into this virtual world. You know, as you give a child an iPad, a very small child an iPad or something like that, and it plays with it for a while, it's completely fixated by what's happening on the screen. As soon as you take that iPad away, it screams and it is uncontrollable, and it will not calm down again until you give the iPad back to it. And as soon as it gets the iPad, it becomes very, very calm again and completely fixated. And people think, oh, it's just the fascination of the screen, but really what it is the dopamine releases. The child gets addicted to the pleasure sensation at a very early age, and life becomes all about pleasure. It becomes all about how much pleasure you experience in each individual moment. So if you have to do anything which leads you away from that pleasure, such as go and cook food, go and interact with someone in a way that is not particularly the way you constructed, or anything that really is in the real world, you're not getting that dopamine fix that you would be getting by clicking icons on the screen. So it's a form of drug addiction, and it leads people into this virtual world. And that's what this system is doing. And it's being very, very cleverly manipulated. And people are being very, very cleverly manipulated into being led into this world. Humanity 2.0. It's not really mankind becoming humanity 2.0 at all. What is happening really is not us merging with machine. What is happening is us becoming the machine. You know, essentially what we are seeing is an attempt to capture the collective consciousness of mankind and imprison it within a system, if we are not already imprisoned within such a system, and this is not already some type of virtual reality that we are in. The truth is a very and extremely elusive thing, especially when looking at this situation we find ourselves in. You know, the nature of this reality is something vastly different to what we're being told. I really would suggest that it is. You know, we are given so little to go on, so little information to go on, and even with the way our language is constructed, we have so little words available in the English language with which to define reality that it's no wonder we have no real idea about what's going on. That's why I keep coming back to the fact that it is so pointless to keep arguing about all these different belief systems. What we need to do is establish the freedom to put all of these arguments to rest and to realize why all of these arguments exist to begin with, why all the mysteries exist to begin with. They only exist because we're not free. People are so worried about what their own personal truth is, rather than facing the common truth that we live in a slavery system. If we do not pay attention to this, then the train that is coming is going to hit us head on right when we least expect it.
Please subscribe. Help us reach 400 subs this year. It will be very delightful. And also share the video to spread the word. You can watch another video, just click left or right. Keep inspiring.